Hi, and welcome back to myexcelonline.com. Today, we have a challenging lesson for you. We are going to use several functions in our spreadsheet and have them all interact together to create a way to enter variables and have the data changed based on the variable that we have entered. In order to accomplish this, we are going to first, once again, review the match function. Then we are going to introduce the hlookup function. And then finally, after that, we will use the VLOOKUP function again to see how it compares with the HLOOKUP function. Before we get started, I would like to go over our new formula today. And our new formula is HLOOKUP. The HLOOKUP formula is very similar to the VLOOKUP formula, with one exception. Instead of looking for our data in columns, we will be looking for our data in rows. So here are the arguments for the HLOOKUP function. The first is lookup value. The second is the table array. The third is the row index number. And the fourth is the range lookup. What do these arguments mean? Well, it means we want to look for this value in this list and get me the value in this row. And do we want this to be an exact match or an approximate match? So I've created a spreadsheet here. And what this spreadsheet includes our salesmen for a paper sales company and their quarterly sales. So across the top in row one, I have the quarter, and in column A, I have the salesmen. I would like to be able to find out which row the salesman entered in cell J3 falls in. And I'm going to accomplish that with the match function. If you remember our lesson on the match function, you will remember that the match argument takes three arguments. The first argument is the lookup value. The second argument is the lookup array. And the third argument is the match type. So in this case, we want to find out which row is the name of the salesman in J3. And we will accomplish that by typing equals match with a left parenthesis. Our first argument is, what value do we want to look up? In this case, I'm going to click cell J3 because that cell has the name of the salesman that I would like to look up. Then I'm going to type a comma, and my next argument is the lookup array. Where is this salesman found? I'm going to highlight from A1 all the way down to A11. And then I'm going to type up a comma. Next, I'm going to be asked what kind of match I want. In this case, I want an exact match. I'm going to double click that and hit enter. And I will see that the salesman for sales that I'm looking for appears in row 3. Is that correct? Yes, it is. Let's change the sales name just to have a test. If I change it to Jim, is he located in row 6? Yes, he is. So this row index number is going to be used in my HLOOKUP function. So now that I know the row where the salesman I'm looking for is found, I can also change the quarter in cell J2 and be able to return that salesman's sales for the quarter that I enter. How are we going to accomplish this? Well, let's do the HLOOKUP function here in cell J5. So click in that cell and type equal HLOOKUP and a left parenthesis. The first argument I'm going to be asked for is my lookup value. In this case, because I'm going horizontally, the value that I want to look up is horizontally across the top of my data set. And where do I find that variable over here? That's in cell J2. So I'm going to click J2. And then I'm going to type a comma. Next, I'm going to be asked for my table array. Where is the data that I want to look up? And don't forget, just like VLOOKUP, the very first row of this data that you pick has to contain this lookup value. So where do I find the data that I'm looking for? In this row right here, row 1. So that has to be the first part of my table array. So I'm going to click on cell A1 and I'm going to hold down my left mouse button and I'm going to drag all the way to the end of my data set, which is in cell E11, because that's where all of my sales numbers are. Then I'm going to type a comma. The next argument is, in what row am I going to return the data? This is a number. And so I could pick row 3 and return Michael's sales, or row 6 and return Jim's sales, or row 8 and return Andy's sales. But I want that, remember, to change with whatever salesman that I have put in J3. I have already calculated which row I want to return using my match function. So in this case, I'm not going to enter a number. I'm going to click on cell J4 because that's where my changing row index number is going to be. I'm going to type a comma, and my final argument is the range lookup. And I want that to be an exact match, not an approximate match. So I'm going to click on false and I'm going to hit enter. So when I look here, I can see that I want Jim's sales for quarter one. Is this number correct? Yes, it is. So what happens if I change the quarter now to quarter three? Am I getting Jim's sales for quarter three? Yes, I am. What if I want to change my salesman to be Pam? Is this a correct number that I am returning? Yes, it is. So it appears that my combination of HLOOKUP and MATCH is allowing me to change both of these variables and return the sales number for that salesman for that quarter. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Notice in this lower section here of my spreadsheet that I have the exact same data as I have up in the table we were just using, except in this case, I now have my quarters vertically and my salespeople going horizontally. So I can actually use the VLOOKUP function in the same exact way that I used the HLOOKUP function above. It all depends on how your data is sorted, whether or not you're going to be doing an HLOOKUP or a VLOOKUP. So let me just review the way to do this with a VLOOKUP really quickly. So in this case, instead of looking for a row argument, I'm going to be looking for a column argument. In what column is the salesperson in cell O15 listed? So let's again use the match function, and I will first be asked for a lookup value. What value do I want to look up? The salesman that I've entered in this cell. And then I'm going to put a comma. Next, I will be asked for the lookup array. Where am I looking for salesmen in this table down here? Well, instead of looking in a column, I'm going to select this row across the top because my data is transposed 90 degrees. And then I'm going to type a comma, and I'm going to again enter an exact match or a zero for that argument and hit enter. So in this case, this is saying that Pam is located in column 10. Is that correct? J is 10. Yes, that is correct. So if I change the salesperson to Jim, I am returned with column 6. Is that correct? Is Jim over here in the sixth column? Yes, he is. So now for my sales, I am going to use a VLOOKUP instead of an HLOOKUP because my data is vertical instead of horizontal. So in this case, I'm going to type equals VLOOKUP and a left parenthesis. What value am I looking up? I would like to know the quarter. And so I'm going to click on cell O14 and type a comma. Next, I'm going to be asked my table array. Where is this data located? Remember with VLOOKUP that the lookup value needs to be in the leftmost column of this table array. So I'm going to click cell A15 all the way down and all the way across to K18. And then I'm going to type a comma. Which column do I wish to return? I wish to return the column for the salesperson entered in O15. So I'm going to click the results of our match function, which is in O16. And then I'm going to type a comma. And do I want an exact match? I'm going to select false right here and hit enter. So in this case, I am returned with $206,000 for gym in quarter three. Is this correct? Yes. How about quarter two? Is this number correct? Yes, it is. How about if I change the salesperson? Let's do Stanley. Is this what Stanley sold in quarter two? Yes, that is correct. So our function is working correctly. I hope you can see the difference of data sets where you would use VLOOKUP as opposed to HLOOKUP. So in review today, we went over the match function because we needed it to return either the row index number or the column index number. We introduced the HLOOKUP function, and we showed the comparison between using the HLOOKUP function and the VLOOKUP function, depending on where your data is located. Hopefully you've learned more today about HLOOKUP and how to use it with the match function and how it compares with VLOOKUP. If you'd like to learn more, please visit our website at myexcelonline.com. Thanks, and hope to see you again soon.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.